Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss about the wastewater collection system. In previous lecture, we already learned about the combined separate system and partial separate system. Now, combined separate system and separate system. So today we discuss about the partial separate system. A portion of storm water during the rain is allowed to enter a sanitary sewer to treatment plant, while the remaining storm water is carried through open drains to the point of disposal. Partially separate system is modified of the separate system, means it is the modified system. So in which the separate system discharging the domestic sewage and industrial waste also contain a portion of the surface drain from back paved yard and roof of the house. A partially separate system is a combined sewage system and separate sewage system. This type of sewage system help decrease the load from a combined sewage system and the lag of separate sewage system. With tackleless technology, it is now possible to create a separate sewage system with minimum disturbance to the old sewer network. Means this partial separate system is actually a modified system that are a combination of combined and separate sewer systems. So why it is need to define this partial separate system? There are some reasons that we use these partial separate systems, where the combined separate system and separate systems are not used. So there are the reasons, like it may raise that the combined system of the sewage has not been found quite suitable under tropical Indian conditions for the reasons outlined below, like the concentration or the concentrated and heavy rainfall during the monsoon period, which at most place last for only 3 to 4 months in a year. Thus there is the considerable variations in the quantity of the sewage flow during the 12 month of the year. The low economy and limited funds available. If there is the combined system or the partial systems are used, so there is the the low funds are available, so these systems are used. Inadequate, the amount of waste of water reaching the sewers because of the vast tract of intervening unsewered areas or due to the other reasons, so that the dry weather flow is generally the tiny proportion of the total flow. Difficulties in the operation and maintenance of the system due to the inadequate supervision of less qualified staff. Local bodies in charge of the work usually do not pay much attention to keeping trained and skilled staff. Because of reasons described above, it has been found the necessary in practice to have a compromise between the separate and combined system and to adopt as far as possible the partially combined or partially separate system of the sewage. The underground sewer system carries only the sanitary or the domestic sewage, into which may also be drained rainwater from the backyard and roof of the house. In contrast, the storm water from the house front and the surface wash the streets and roads may separately discharge into the water course running near or to the same low-lying areas at some further distance. Now the advantage of partially separate systems. There are some advantage as compared to the combined separate system and separate systems. It simplifies the drainage of the houses. Second, it provides a reasonable size of the sewers and the economical. The rainwater provides some safeguard against the silting in the sewer. It combines the advantages of both separate system and combined system. Next, the sewers to be provided are the reasonable size and hence their cleaning is not very difficult. The stormwater eliminates the chance of their choking. Moreover, the sewers are completely clean during the rainy seasons. The problem of drainage of stormwater from houses is simplified. Disadvantage of partially separate system. Now the next starts the disadvantage of partial separate systems. First one is the low velocity during the dry period. Second, storm overflows may be found necessary. Next, the storm water admitted in a sewers may increase a load on pumping and treatment units. During dry weather, when there is no rain water, the velocity of flow will be low, and thus the self cleansing velocity may not be achieved. Stormwater overflows may be required to be provided. These are in general disadvantage. And this is the diagram of a partially separate system. In this diagram we can see that there are the separate systems of drainage and overflow during the heavy rainfalls, so that there is easy to collect the water where the rainy seasons is max. There is again the separate sewage system where all the sewage or the sanitary water collected from the house industries, so that water is collected another pipelines, and these waters or that sanitary water undergoes the treatment in a treatment plant, and then that water is ready to reuse or the expose in a river. So these are the general information about the partial separate system. Now the design of storm and sanitary sewer system. This is a very important part of designing. And this is depend on the various conditions. So the first one is the designing of a stormwater. Generally the storm sewers are designed to provide the safe passage of vehicles and to collect the convey and discharge for the frequently occurring low return period storm sewer design. Second, it involves the estimation runoff from an area design of the sewer and other hydraulic structures in the drainage system. The total quantity of sewage generated per day is estimated as the product of forecasted population at the end of design period, considering per capita sewage generation and approximate peak factor. Or that appropriate peak factors. Then the next one is the per capita sewage generation can be considered as 75% to 80% of the per capita water supplies per day. The increase in population also result in increase in per capita water demand and hence per capita production of the sewage is to be considered. Next is, in this increase in water demand occurs due to increase in living standards, betterment in economical conditions, changes in habit of peoples, and enhanced demand for the public utility. Now the next concept is the factors affecting the quantity of sewage flow. Then first factor is population, second is the type of area, then third one is the rate of water supply, and fourth is the infiltration and exfiltration. The quantity of sanitary sewage is mainly affected by these all factors. So in addition to above, it may also affected by habits of people, number of industries, and water pressure, then plants, etc. The quantity of sanitary sewage directly depend on the population. As the population increases, the quantity of sanitary sewage also increases. The quantity of water supplies is equal to the rate of water supply multiplied by the population. There are several methods used for the forecasting the population of a community. Next factor is the quantity of sanitary sewage also depends on the type of area, as the residential, industrial, commercial, etc. The quantity of sewage depends from residential area depends on the rate of water supply to the area, which is expressed a liters per capita per day. Quantity of sewage produced by various industries depend on their various industrial process, which is different for each industry, or it is depend on that respective industries. So the similarity, the quantity of sewage obtained from the commercial and the public places can be determined by studying the development of other such a places. Now the first one is the design of storm sewers. The quantity of used water discharged into the sewer system should be little less than that of the amount water originally supplied to the community. Quantity of sewage may be considered to be nearly equal to the quantity of water supplied, groundwater, infiltration and exfiltration. So infiltration causes increase to the legitimate flows in urban sewage systems. Infiltration represents a slow response process resulting in increased flow, mainly due to the seasonally elevated groundwater entering the drainage system and primarily occurring through defects in the pipe network. Now the exfiltration. This exfiltration represents losses from the sewer pipes, resulting in reducing conveyance flow, and is due to the leak from the defects in the sewer pipe walls, as well as overflow discharge into the manholes, chambers, and connecting surface water pipes. The physical defects are due to the combinations of factors including poor constructions and pipe joint fitting, root penetrations, illicit connections, biochemical corrosion, soil conditions, and traffic loading, as well as aggressive groundwater. It is clear that infiltration and exfiltration involves the flows passing through the physical defects in the sewer fabric, and they will often occurs concurrently during fluctuations in groundwater levels. Now the design period of stormwater. The design flow is the maximum flow that can pass through a specified structure safely. It determines this design flow. The possibility of occurrence has been fixed. Once this is fixed, the design flow magnitude can be determined. So the following are the design periods that can be considered for the different components of the sewage scheme. First one is the laterals less than 15 cm diameter for the full development areas. Then the trunk or the main sewers for the 40 to 50 years. Then treatment units for 15 to 20 years. This is for the full development area. Then the pumping plant for 5 to 10 years. When the rainfall overs the ground surface, a part of it percolate into the ground, a part of evaporate in the atmosphere, and the remaining part of overflows as a storm water. This quantity of storm water is very large as compared to that of sanitary sewage. Generally, a design frequency is selected to match the facility's cost, amount of traffic, then potential flood hazards to the property, expected level of service, then political considerations and budgetary constraints. That considering the magnitude and risk associated with the damage from the large flood events. So that frequency with which a given flood can be expected to occur is the reciprocal of the probability or chance that is flood will be equaled or exceeded in a given year. If a flood has a 20% chance of being equaled or exceeded each year, then over a long period of the time, the flood will be equaled or exceeded on an average of once every 5 years. This is called the recurrence interval. Thus, the exceedance probability equal to the 100 divided by recurrence interval. So, the generally to design the drainage facilities, the recurrence interval is to be important. Now, the next is the factors affecting on a stormwater. First one is the rainfall intensity and durations. Second, area of catchment, slope and shape of catchment area. Next, nature of soil and degree of porosity. Initial state of the catchment. If the rainfall intensity and duration is more, the large will be the quantity of storm water available. If the rainfall takes place very slowly, even though it continue for the whole day, the quantity of storm water available will be less. Greater the catchment area, greater will be the amount of storm water. Fan shaped and steep areas contribute more quantity of the storm water. Now, how to calculate the quantity of storm water? In general, there are the two methods which are used for calculating or to estimate the quantity of storm water. These are rational method and empirical formula method. In these two methods, there are a sewer system in a network of the pipe used to convey storm runoff and or the wastewater in an area. Design of a sewer system involves the determination of diameters, slopes, crown or the invert elevations for the each pipe in the system. In rational method, it is only for the drainage area which is less than the 50 hectares, and empirical formula method is the only for the drainage area that is greater than that of 50 hectares. This is the quite difference between this rational method and empirical formula method. If the area is less than 50 hectare, then it is rational method, and if the area is greater than that of 50 hectares, then that method is the empirical formula method. Hope so you understand all the concept in separate sewer system. Thank you.